your Son, our Savior. Thank you for this Christmas Eve, for these who have gathered in this place. And Father, may we lay aside all of the other cares that we have and come to the manger tonight. Thank you, and bless us as we come in Jesus' name. Amen. Be seated, please. Once again, welcome as you come in, and hopefully you have a little tea light, a little light for our later on in the service. We're going to light those as we sing Silent Night. If you haven't picked one of those up, send someone to the back to make sure that you have a light, and we'll be able to share at that time. But welcome. Throughout the service, as I mentioned, a number of our people and our young people are going to be sharing in the service, and so you'll want to enjoy that. First off, we have Anne Marie Williams is going to come and share Carol of the Bells. Part of the Christmas season are singing the Christmas carols together, so we're going to sing just a short medley of songs. Now Joy to the World and Hark the Herald Angels Sing. First of all, Joy to the World. First word is joy. That's a smile word.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth her King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of His righteousness, and wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders, wonders of His love.
Hark the herald angels sing. Hark, that's an exclamation.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. Angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Prince of Peace. Hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
The scriptures tell us about Jesus. And tell us about this night. Bob Jackson, come share the word with us.
The Old Testament has many prophecies about Jesus and many about his coming birth. And I'm going to start in the book of Micah. But thou, Bethlehem Ephratah, though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of thee shall come forth unto me, that is to be ruler in Israel, whose goings forth have been from of old, from everlasting. And now in Isaiah, therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. And now turning to the second chapter of Luke. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was the first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were, in that same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered of those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told to them.
Now let's sing the second verse of our theme, O Come, All Ye Faithful.
Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation. O sing, all ye bright hosts of heaven above.
Kraus is going to come and share. Once again, we're going to sing as we share together, "Go Tell It on the Mountain," and "What Child Is It?" Let's stand together as we proclaim from the mountaintops, "Jesus Christ is born."
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in the lowly manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
What child is this?
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch our keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold and myrrh, come peasant king to own him, the King of kings salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Thank you. Be seated, please. The energetic portion of the program is going to be right now. We're going to invite all the kids that would like to. And if you have to come along with them, parent or two, that's okay. And we're going to meet right over here in the green room. Come join me, kids. Come join me. Have a seat. See, Janet has joined us. Have a seat. Have a seat. Come have a seat anywhere up here. Big guys, little guys, good to see you. You guys go ahead and go on up on the stage and get ready, okay? Have a seat there, caller man. See if anybody else join us. Okay, now we're going to do some special things because we have some special young people that are going to do some special things. Can we say special?
Special. It sounds special.
Okay, so we're going to enjoy this. First of all, Owen and Reagan are going to share a special Jingle Bells with us, okay? Let's listen. All right, give him a hand. Now it's our turn. Let's sing Jingle Bells. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. That was very churchy. Now, I like the hay. Everybody's going to say, but we're going to sing it really loud, and maybe we can get these people to join us. What do you think? All right, here we go. All right, well, once again. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey!
All right, good job, guys. You guys can come down. Now, Morgan is going to come and play a special song for us. Morgan, you want to speak before or after? All right, let's get you a microphone. It's a little dangerous giving Morgan a microphone, but...
Okay, here you go. This one. Okay, so you guys can tell what song I'm playing Happy Birthday. And when I decided that I wanted to play this and I kept telling people that this is what I was playing, they're really confused. So... But they had to think about it for a while, then be like, oh, yeah, it's Jesus' birthday. So when I'm playing it, would you guys want to sing it when I play it? So, yeah. And no, I'm not texting
him. That's good. Hey to you, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jesus. Happy birthday to you. Let's do that again. Good job. All right. This time, put some oomph into it. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jesus. Happy birthday to you. All right, good job, Morgan. And now, Lily's going to share with her dad, and they're going to do Away in the Manger, okay?
Christmas every day.
Dear children, thy tender care.
to heaven to live with thee there.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus, no crying needed. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay.
Merry Christmas.
Okay, before you go sit down again, let's talk about Christmas. How many of you would like to get a present tomorrow morning?
Me too.
Christmas is a lot of fun, isn't it?
Yes.
And there's a lot of good presents and a lot of good food. What do you like to eat at Christmas?
Eggnog.
What do you like to eat? Yeah.
Turkey.
Hot chocolate. Turkey. RJ.
Cinnamon buns.
Milk. What do you like?
Green beans.
Owen? Mashed potatoes.
Santa's cookies.
Cookies.
Shrimp.
This girl's got expensive taste. Eggnog, shrimp. At our age, she'd have gout. But there's lots of stuff we enjoy about Christmas. But I know that your focus tonight... Our focus is on Jesus, and that's what Christmas is all about. So lots of things that we celebrate at Christmas, lots of things we do, but it's about Jesus, His being born as our Savior. So keep that in mind in all your fun and celebration. Let's pray together. Father, thank You for Jesus. Thank You that we can learn, even as children and as young people and young adults, all of us, that the reason for this season is Jesus. Bless them now. In His name I pray. Amen. Okay, go ahead. Let's sing that third verse, "O Come All You Faithful." Moment, we're going to have an offering this evening. Janet's going to play through "O Come All You Faithful" as we share our offering. You'll find yourself humming along. That's good. Our offering tonight is for our international missions. Every year during Christmas, we take a special offering during the month of December into January where we give to international missions. And so on Christmas Eve, we set aside anything you give. It goes directly to international missions. There's envelopes in front of you if you just want to leave a gift in the offering plate, that's fine. It's just a way of us, during worship, saying thank you, Lord, for your gift to us. So as the ushers come now, let's pray to bless the gifts. And then as we give those gifts, reflect on adoring Him. Father, thank you for the gift of Jesus. And for now, as we have the time to share that gift, Father, bless us as we reach out across the world to share Jesus. We pray in His name. Amen. Amen. Craig and Jess are going to come now and share some special music with us.
Thank you.
All the food's made? All the plans are made? Karen's shaking her head, no, I'm not ready yet. All right, well, whether or not, Christmas is here. And we're so grateful to celebrate this time. But I want to invite you to do one more thing tonight. I want to invite you, all this month, we have been coming to different places in the Christmas story. We started in Nazareth. We traveled to Jerusalem. Sunday, we were in Bethlehem. Tonight, I invite you to come to the manger in Bethlehem. And I want you to watch something, and then I'll talk a little bit about it. But listen to the message in this.
Kruger, I'm custodian over at the Beck Apartments, but you know that, don't you? You know that. I guess nobody here can see me or hear me except you. You. I didn't bring a gift, I guess that's not important. Thank you for everything you've done for me. As long as I can remember, you've been right by my side. I'll never forget when you walked with me right in those first few hours after I lost Martha. I have always been able to count on you when I felt dark inside and when you were right there, right every time. Right there. Even when I didn't feel good about myself, I knew that you cared for me enough, and that made me feel better. Like the time I got mad with Mabel Huntington because she broke her pipes on purpose, just so she could have somebody to see while I came up and fixed them for her. Boy, I hollered at her, I hollered real loud. But then I got to thinking, you love Mabel just as much as you love me, and I should treat her the way you want me to. I believe I talked to you about that at the time. I started visiting her, and we became friends, and I saw her almost every day until the day she died. I love you. You're my closest, my finest friend, and that means that I can hold my head high wherever I go. Thank you.
Jimmy Stewart said, this is what toward the end of his career, and he said in all the roles that he ever played, he didn't have to act in this one. What would you do If suddenly tonight you stood at the manger, what would you say? What would you feel? To that, Jesus says simply, come to the manger. Come, let us adore Him. Yes, there's lots of questions. We don't understand it all. We've got messes in our lives and lots of things that would pull us away. But simply come, He says. Come, let us adore Him. So bow your heads with me. And take a moment before this season, this day and tomorrow gets wild and crazy. And perhaps say some things to Jesus right now as you're at the manger. Come. Dear Jesus, thank you. Thank you that you came, that you lived, that you died for us, and that you rose again to give us life. Oh Lord, we have a lot of thoughts and a lot of ideas, but help us to focus on you. Lord, help us to say, we love you. Thank you for the gift that is Christmas. And may we trust you tonight. Lay aside our fears, our doubts, and simply in the honesty of a child, say thank you, Jesus. Here is my heart. Here is my life. Thank you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You need your candle now. We're going to stand together and we're going to sing Silent Night. So now it's time to turn them on. And as we sing this together, we're going to lower the lights and sing it in reverence as we stand at the manger with Jesus.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm. All is bright round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, darkness flies, all is light. Shepherds hear the angels sing, Alleluia, hail the King. Christ the Savior is born, Christ the Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light, radiant beams from thy holy face. With the dawn of reason, us, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
Father, tonight as we hold the candle, as we share the light, we do so because Jesus is the light of the world. Let us go forth as his ambassadors, as those who have been to the manger like the shepherds, and share what we have experienced. Share who Jesus is to us. Go with us. Thank you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Please stay where you are. The house lights are going to come up. Jim Hess has something he wants to say, and then I have something I want to share with you. Beware of deacons bearing gifts. Kathy's right here. Come on down. Uh-oh, what have we got here?
Is it bomb? No. Look, this is the year, this is the time of year of giving gifts. And we consider you two a great gift to us.
Thank you.
And we appreciate your calling, Steve.
Thank you.
That you share with us every Sunday morning.
Thank you.
And obeying that call as our pastor, as our shepherd.
Thank you.
You.
Don't say anything.
There's not a one of us, Lord, that doesn't need to thank the Lord for you, for the cards and the gifts and the kind words that you give us. And this is just a small token of what we really feel in our heart for
thank you.
May you have a merry, merry Christmas.
Thank you very much. And we say thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. I don't have to stay.
You don't have to say anything, do you?
No.
We just want to say thank you very much. It's our privilege to be in ministry with you. And Merry Christmas to you. Now, before you leave, I got one more thing for you. My favorite Christmas video. As you go, enjoy. Merry Christmas.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where those treetops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow, the snow. Then I am dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write. May your days, may your days be merry and bright. Christmas is beautiful.